Hi, welcome to my 11th video in the playlist of UPSC Maths Optional Linear Algebra. So far, we are solving the sums based on problems on linear transformation. That is, we need to find the matrix for a given linear transformation, and then we want to find the null space, range space, and then kernel, nullity, etc. So we are going to continue the problems. So far, we have finished maximum all the sums in this paper. Now, in this video, I am going to solve 7th problem and the 9th problem. Now, I already said you take 8th and 11th problem as exercise. It's very easy. The 8th problem is you need to find the matrix and then you need to find the solution for Ax equal to 0. 11th problem, you just have to find only the matrix. Now, the 7th problem is show that B is equal to 100 110 111 is a basis for R3. Now, you know how to show this is a basis. To show this is a basis, I already taught in the previous videos. First, we want to show it is linearly independent. To show it is linearly independent, we should say that rank of A and rank of AO is equal to n. Here n is 3 here. So we want to show that the rank of this is equal to 3. If it is equal to 3, then it is linearly independent, and obviously it will span the whole R3. So it will become a basis. So I'm sure that you will prove that these vectors 100 110 111 is a basis for R3. You just find the rank. So you watched the previous videos before watching this video, so you will label this. You can prove that this is a basis in 1 to 2 minutes. Now I'm not going to show that this is a basis. It's very easy. You watched the previous videos. Now, this is an important question. What is given here? Now, the transformation matrix is given. That is, T of 100 is equal to 1100, T of 110 is equal to 111, and T of 111 is equal to 110. Now we need to find T of x comma y comma z. So in the previous sums, the transformation is given and then we need to find the matrix for a given transformation. But here, the matrix is given, we need to find the transformation. It's a reverse process. Now, what should we do now? Now, it's a very easy question. Now, look at here. T of 1, 0, 0 is equal to 100. T of 110 is equal to 111 and T of 111 is equal to 110. We need to find T of x comma y comma z. So this is the formula to find T of x comma y comma z. T of x comma y comma z is equal to A into T of E1 plus B into T of E2 plus C into T of E3. Now we need to find A, B, C and then T of E1, T of E2 and T of E3. Now, E1, we should take E1 as a basis vector. So, E1 is, here is E1, 100, E2 is, I am taking the basis as E1, E2 and E3. So, E2 is 110 and E3 is 111. Clear? Now, T of x, y, z becomes A times T of 1, 0, 0 plus B times T of 1, 1, 0 plus C times T of 1, 1, 1. Now, A times T of 1, 0, 0 is 100. So, it is given 100 plus B times T of 1, 1, 0 is 111 plus C times T of 1, 1, 1 is 110. So, 110. Now we need to find A, B, C to get T of x, y, z. So how to find A, B, C. Now to find A, B, C, you just consider x, y, z is equal to, you don't need to put T here. So x, y, z will become A times E1 plus b times e2 plus c times e3. So you just remove t over. So this will become a times e1. e1 is 1 0 0 plus b times e2 is 1 1 0 plus c times e3 is 1 comma 1 comma 1. Now here it is x comma y comma z. Now you get the first term. The first term will become equating first term. This will become x is equal to, here it is a, here it is b, here it is c. Clear? Now you get the second term. Here it is y, here it is 0, right? 0 times a. Here it will become b, here it will become c. Right? Now you get the third term. Z. Here third term is z. Here third term is a, 0 into a. So 0 term, a term will not be there. Again, third term is 0 into b, so b term will not be there. So z is equal to only c. Now, very important question. Now, very important note. Now, you need to find a, b, c in terms of x, y, z. So, find a, b, c in terms of x, y, z. Now, here it becomes c is equal to z. C is equal to z. Now here it will become b is equal to y minus c. So c is z. So this will become y minus z. Now you should always find a, b, c in terms of x, y, z. So you should not get c here. So I'm substituting c is equal to z here. Now here it will become a is equal to x minus b minus c. Right? Now x minus b is y minus z minus c is z. So this will become x minus y plus z minus z. This will be cancelled. So we have only x minus y. So I have a is equal to x minus y, b is equal to y minus z, and c is equal to z. So we have found a, b, and c. Now you substitute a, b, c in. You take it as equation 1. So you substitute a, b, c in equation 1. So what will happen now? So t of x comma y comma z is equal to a. A is x minus y into 1 comma 0 comma 0 plus b. B is y minus z into 1 comma 1 comma 1 plus c. C is z 1 comma 1 comma 0. Now you write equate the first term. The first term will become x minus y, right? So I'll add another step. So this will become x minus y comma 0 comma 0. If I multiply x minus y, it'll be, have here, this will become y minus z comma y minus z comma y minus z. It will become z comma 0. So I'm just multiplying x minus y minus z and z with the vectors. So what we'll have here is, now we get the first term. Equate the first term. I have x minus y is the first term here. Here it is y minus z. Here it is plus z. Right? Now you get the second term. 0, 0 plus y minus z plus z. Now you get the third term. 0 plus y minus z plus 0. So this will become, this y will become cancelled. This set will become cancelled. So I have only x here. Here, this set will become cancelled. So I have only y here. Here I have y minus z. So this is the transformation. X comma y comma z is equal to x comma y minus z. So this is the transformation for the given matrix. Now, this question carries 12 marks, so it's very easy. You need to find the transformation if the matrix is given. Now, I'm going to verify that this is the transformation. So, you don't need to do workout from now. So, I'm just going to verify that this is the correct answer. So, what I got here is t of x, y, z is equal to x comma y comma y minus z. So this is the transformation which I got, right? Now you find t of what is the basis here? 100 110 111. So you find t of 100. So this will become 1, y is 0, y minus z is 0 minus 0. So it will become 1, 0, 0. Now t of 1, 1, 0. So x is 1, y is 1, z is 0. So this will become x, y minus z. So 1 minus 0. So this will become 1, 1, 1. Now next t of 1, 1, 1. So this will become x is 1, y is 1, y minus z is 1 minus 1. So this will become 1, 1, 0. See here, t of 1, 0, 0 is 100. So we'll get 100. And t of 1, 1, 0 is 1, 1, 1. So we'll get 1, 1, 1. And t of 1, 1, 1 is 1, 1, 0. So we'll get 1, 1, 0. So this is the transformation which it transforms the given vector to this vector. Clear? Now I'm going to move on to the next question, which is the last question in this. Now this is a problem based on linear transformation. This is the last problem based on linear transformation. So with this we are completing the topic, that is the matrix of linear transformation, and then in the next video we are going to move on to the next topic. So the last problem is, now look at the question here. D is a function from x to x, x is equal to pn. Now d p of x is equal to p1 plus 2 p2x plus 3 p3x square, where p of x is equal to something is given. You need to find the matrix of T. See, this asked in 2007. It has 15 marks. It's very big. It can hardly take you 2 to 3 minutes to solve the problem. So you'll get 15 marks. Now, look at here. P of x. D of P of x. Now, you always look at here. P of x is a domain. And D P of x is a mapping. So this will be a codomain. So it is given that x d is a function from x to x, but it is given to confuse you. But you look at the domain. What is the domain here? P of x. What is the degree of domain? 3. So domain is P3. So the domain is P3. What is the codomain here? So codomain is the mapping. So it is degree 2. So therefore t is a function from p3 to p2. Clear? So d is a function from p3 to p2. It is given x pn to pn, but you look at the domain is a degree 3, codomain is degree 2, so it is p2. Now you need to find the matrix. Now what is the basis for p3? You know the basis for p3. So you should have basis for P3 is 1x, x square and x cube. They didn't give any basis here, so you should take this as a standard basis. Now domain for P2 is P3. The domain for P2 is 1x and x square. Right? Now first D of 1. So D of 1. So if it is d of 1, you should think as p0, 1 times p0, 0 times x, 0 times x square, 0 times x cube. So here p1 is 0, p2 is 0, p3 is 0, p0 is 1, right? 1 times 1. So p0 is 1. So this transformation is transformed to p1 plus 2 p2x plus 3 p3x square. So P1 is 0, P2 is 0, P3 is 0. So D of 1 is transformed to P1 is 0 plus P2. 2 times P2 is 0 again plus 3 times P3 is 0 again. So this is equal to 0. Now D of X. So you should think D of X as 0 times 1 plus 1 times X, 0 times x square, 0 times x cube. So here p1 is 1 and all of this are 0. So this is transformed to p1 is 1 plus 2 p2. P2 is 0 plus 3 p3 is 0 x square. So I recommend you to watch the previous videos before watching this video. So if you watch this video straight away, you won't understand. So if you gone through all the videos, it will be very easy for you. You can do it in yourself. So please watch previous videos. So this will become only 1. Now d of x square. You should think this as 0 times 1, 0 times x plus 1 times x square, 0 times x cube. So p2, right? p2 is x square. Look at here. P naught, quotient of x is p1. So it is p1 is 0, p0 is 0, p3 is 0. So you have only p2 as 1. So this will become p1. p1 is 0 plus 2 times p2 is 1. Plus 3 times 0 x square. So this will become only 2x. Now, this is transformed to, now d of x cube. D of x cube, you should think this as p0 is 0, p1 is 0, p2 is 0, but p3 is 1, right? Because we have only x cube here. So quotient of x cube is p3. So p3 is 1. So this is transformed to p1. p1 is 0 plus 2 times p2 is x plus 3 times p3 is 1x square. So this is 3x square. Now you need to find the matrix. So what I got here is d of 1 is d of 1. So d of 1 is 0. Now you should write this 0 as a linear combination of basis of p2. So this is 0 times 1, 0 times x, 0 times x square. Now d of x, what I got d of x is 1. So you should write this as 1, 1, 0x plus 0x square. So if you watch this video before videos, you will be clearly understand this. So d of x square. So what I got for d of x square? D of x square is 2x. Now I should write this as 0 times 1 plus 2 times x plus 0 times x square. Now what I got for d of x cube? D of x cube I got is 3x square. So this is 0 times 1 plus 0 times 0 plus 3 times x square. Now this is the scalars. So I should write the scalars vertically. So it will become 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0. 003. Now this is the matrix for t with respect to the basis. Clear? So look at here. This can only take 2 to 3 minutes. If you know the concept, you can finish in within 1 to 2 minutes. But it carries 15 marks. So you understand the importance of this topic. So with this, we are completing the problems based on matrix of linear transformation. So if you have any doubt, you can comment. And if you have any problems based on this, you can also post this. I'll post that as a video. So you keep on studying, keep on revising all the 11 videos. So we have completed almost 50% of linear algebra syllabus. So look at here, we have completed vector space over R and C, linear dependence and linear independence, subspace, basis, dimension, linear transformation, rank, nullity and matrix of linear transformation. So we have completed up to this. So the next video we will start the algebra of matrices. This is very easy. Algebra of matrices, row reduction and rank and inverse for matrix. So we already know how to find the rank for a given matrix. So we are just going to continue that, how to find the rank for a given matrix. So to find rank, we will use row column reduction. So we can cover this year from here in 2 to 3 videos. We just want to know how to find rank and inverse of a matrix, and then solution of linear equations, and then eigenvalue problem. So that we will complete the whole syllabus in almost 30 to 35 videos. So this is 11th video. So you keep on sharing so that someone will get benefited. And also watch this video above 360 pixel in your settings so that the quality will be good. So we'll see the next video. Goodbye. Thank you.